After skin cancer, prostate cancer is the most common cancer diagnosed in men in the United States. Roughly 1 in 7 men will develop prostate cancer at some point in their lifetime. So it is a cancer that will very likely affect you or someone you know. Also, because it ranks second only to lung cancer as the cause of cancer deaths among males, it is an important disease to understand. In this video, we will be discussing how prostate cancer is diagnosed and treated. What are the signs or symptoms that have prostate cancer? What is PSA? How is prostate cancer diagnosed? I've been diagnosed with prostate cancer. What are my next steps? What is the prostate? Prostate cancer affects the prostate gland, which is a male organ located in the pelvis next to the bladder. The prostate has only one function, which is solely reproductive in nature, and it is to produce semen. It is a small gland, usually the size of a walnut. What are the signs or symptoms that have prostate cancer? In the vast majority of situations, there are no signs or symptoms that alert the patient to the presence of prostate cancer. Some potential symptoms of prostate cancer are difficulty with urination and slow urinary stream, although these symptoms are much more likely to be present in benign prostatic enlargement. However, we are fortunate to have good screening tools to diagnose prostate cancer. The mainstay of screening is a blood test known as PSA. Digital rectal exam, or DRE, or when the doctor examines the prostate with a finger, is also another important diagnostic tool. What is PSA? PSA, which stands for prostate-specific antigen, is a protein made by the prostate and is detected by a simple blood test. PSA levels can increase when prostate cancer is present. However, elevation in the PSA alone is not sufficient to diagnose prostate cancer and must be followed by a biopsy to confirm the cancer diagnosis. When should I start PSA screening? Screening for prostate cancer depends on many factors, such as family history, age, and ethnicity. Those with a high risk of developing prostate cancer should begin PSA screening in their 40s. These are individuals with a strong family history of prostate cancer and/or are African American. It is important to talk to your doctor about your risk factors and when to begin screening for prostate cancer, as those factors may influence your decision. For most other men, PSA screening generally commences in their 50s. What is a normal PSA result? There is no normal PSA result, and a variety of factors can influence PSA other than prostate cancer. PSA can be influenced by one's age, the size of the prostate, and the presence of infection or inflammation. Is there an imaging study that can diagnose prostate cancer? Another useful screening modality is imaging the prostate using magnetic resonance imaging, or MRI. Although MRI is not perfect in its accuracy in finding cancer, it can help refine biopsy to target any areas of suspicion seen on MRI to improve the accuracy of the biopsy technique. How is prostate cancer diagnosed? PSA and MRIs are modalities only used for screening, and prostate biopsy is the only way to definitively diagnose prostate cancer. How does the biopsy work? The biopsy is done using ultrasound, and small needles are used to sample the prostate. The ultrasound probe is gently placed in the rectum, and the biopsies of the prostate are directed through the rectum into the prostate under local anesthesia. As the rectum in this location does not have much in the way of pain receptors, the vast majority of patients are able to tolerate the procedure without additional anesthesia requirements. In cases where an MRI was done and shows a suspicious area, an MRI fusion biopsy is done. This is when the MRI and real-time ultrasound images are fused so that the information from the MRI can be used to target the area of suspicion, which leads to a much more accurate biopsy. I've been diagnosed with prostate cancer. What are my next steps? Prostate cancer represents a disease with a wide spectrum of severity, some of which are more aggressive and others which are slow-growing and unaggressive. Not all men diagnosed with prostate cancer require treatment. If prostate cancer is diagnosed in its early stages, it can often be watched without treatment. This is known as active surveillance. Likewise, for elderly men with limited life expectancy, who are more likely to pass away from a cause other than the prostate cancer, in these situations, the cancer is watched and not treated. For men with prostate cancer that is more aggressive, treatment options should be considered. Treatment options for prostate cancer include radiation and/or surgery. The decision to treat or not treat prostate cancer should be discussed with your oncologist or cancer doctor, as there are pros and cons to each option. Like most cancers, prostate cancer that is found early has the best chance for treatment success and cure. What are the side effects to treatment? As mentioned earlier, although the prostate's function is solely reproductive in nature, the side effects to any prostate cancer treatment can include urinary incontinence and erectile dysfunction. This is due to the prostate's close proximity to structures that govern these specific functions. In general, the risk of incontinence overall is low, and the risk of erectile dysfunction is higher, although that is usually dependent upon the patient's baseline erectile function. Those who are younger with better baseline erectile function do better and can have good outcomes after treatment. What does surgery of prostate cancer entail? The surgical procedure to eradicate prostate cancer is known as a prostatectomy. The goal of prostatectomy is to remove the entire prostate and some neighboring lymph nodes. The whole prostate is removed so that cancer does not recur in any prostate tissue that is left behind. The vast majority of prostatectomies performed in the United States today utilize a minimally invasive technique known as robotic surgery, which uses small incisions, three-dimensional, high-definition, magnified vision, and highly maneuverable instrumentation to perform this delicate operation. Because a minimally invasive technique is used, recovery is quick, and most patients leave the hospital the next day. What does radiation treatment of prostate cancer entail? Radiation treatment techniques are more varied than surgical techniques. Radiation usually takes the form of radioactive seed placement or external beam radiation administration, or a combination of both. Hormonal blockade is often used in conjunction with radiation treatment, where the male hormone testosterone is blocked for a period of time, as this has been found to improve cancer control outcomes. When external beam treatment is used, the treatment usually will take some weeks to complete. How aggressive is prostate cancer? In general, prostate cancer is not felt to be an aggressive cancer, which is why options such as active surveillance exist. However, it is important to remember that prostate cancer is still the number two cause of male cancer deaths in the United States. Prostate cancer can act aggressively, and those who are young and have high-risk forms of prostate cancer can have their life expectancy decreased by it, which underscores the importance of screening. Reach out to your doctor if you have other questions or want to ask about prostate cancer.